Okay, so good morning everyone. So today, before starting off with today's lecture, I will have a quick glance of what we have discussed in the previous classes. Let me share this screen. Yeah, is the screen visible?
Yes,
Okay,
sir.
so let's quickly have a glance of what we discussed in this chapter, the second chapter under module 1, right? So it is all about the flow control. In the flow control, we learned about different kind of flow control statements, the Boolean values, Boolean operators, the comparison between operators. We looked out after a few set of examples how these operators can play a role. Then the Boolean operations among binary Boolean operators, that is true and false, how those Boolean values are compared and bring out to ultimately a single Boolean value. Then mixing of the Boolean and comparison operators, and then we stopped at the elements of flow control. We discussed element of flow control in the previous class, the previous lecture, and as most of you have few of you, not most of you, few of you have already answered on the previous lecture what I have given you to answer in the comment section. So all of them, those who have answered, are right. So this is the answer. It is true here, right? So those who have not, I believe you have not read the question or not gone through the lecture. Anyways, so element of flow control we discussed in the previous class. We had a view on what is condition, how can condition play a role in making a decision or a flow in the execution of the program. The block, what is the block of code? When a condition gets satisfied or not satisfied, then what is the block of, what can be called as a block of code, is that we discussed, right? It can be a single line or a set of lines. We had few examples with respect to it, and also the program execution. We had a simple hello world program in Python, and we had a flow of how that particular gets executed, right? So flow control statements, like if statements with syntax and other parameters, we had discussed with the flow chart of the if statement, the else statement, right? And also the elif statement, the combination of elif, multiple if else statements. And also we had an example. Ultimately, we end up discussing a flow chart, that is for the multiple elif statement, right? So just to have a recap of the multiple elif statement, when a particular condition is true, it ultimately executes the block, the particular block of code followed by the condition, and eventually end the loop, the complete loop. And once it is, if the elif condition is false, if the first if condition is false, it gets into an elif condition, and then it follows the same thing. The moment it is true, it ends the loop, else it checks for the other condition, and so on. So it's a loop, right? It's a multiple elif else if statement, which is called as elif statements, multiple elif statements. So we had an example of vampire.py, the vampire program. Now we'll carry forward the same example, and we will have a little modification to it to discuss how this particular program can be executed in a different format using this again elif statement by changing the control. We'll be able to see how can we change the control of this execution, what we are saying, right? So here I have a program. Let me zoom in. So here is one program, let's name it Vampire 2. And as you can see, there is a change compared to the previous Vampire program. So let me bring out the previous Vampire program. Yeah. So here you can see we discussed, like, if name is equal to Alice, then print hi Alice. Elif less than 12, if the age is less than 12, it prints that you are not Alice kiddo, right? And else if, that means if this condition is not true, it moves to this elif condition, that is, it checks for whether the age is greater than 2000, right? So if the age is greater than 2000, let's say the input given by the user is greater than something 2000, so it prints that unlike you, Alice is not an undead immortal vampire, right? And the third elif statement is, elif age is greater than 100, then print you are not Alice's granny, right? So this was the flow that we checked in our previous lecture. We executed this and we saw how this, when this particular elif statement gets concluded or executed, and how the instructions or a few blocks of codes below few elif condition get skipped, right? So here in today's program, you can see there is a small change, because in order to execute that difference, to defer the flow of the program, the few statements are changed. As you can clearly make it out that the second and the third statements are swapped, right? So the first and second condition, that is, if name is Alice, print hi Alice, and elif age is less than 12, it prints that you are not Alice kiddo. So these two statements are same, but as you can see, compared to previous program, that is our vampire.py program, the third statement, this third statement and fourth statement, they are exchanged or swapped, you can say, right? Previous, in previous condition and the previous program, we were checking that else if greater than 2000, this condition, as before this condition, that is elif age is greater than 100, but now we have swapped it. So as you can see there, that this particular statement, that is elif condition, will not at all get executed, right? Because if the age is greater than 100, anything beyond 100 will automatically print the block of code under that. So as you can see that because the age is greater than 100 condition is true, right? So even if the user enter, let's say 3000, which is greater than 100, and it is greater than 2000 also, right? So if the age is greater than 100 condition is true, then the string you are not Alice granny, right? So this is printed, and the rest of the Alice part, that is this below code will never get executed, right? This is skipped, this particular if elif condition and the block of code followed by this elif condition, which is age greater than 2000, is skipped, right? Because our condition is getting true here itself and we are exiting here, right? So let me go back to the flow chart. Yeah, so let me zoom out a bit. So you can make it out here that this upper part, all two conditions, the initial two conditions are same as what we discussed in the previous lectures, that name is equal to Alice, if it is true, it gets print and it's the end of the elif. If it is false, again, age is less than 2. Let's take an input that user has given 3000 itself as the value for the age. Okay, so once this condition is true, that name is equal to Alice, if it is equal to Alice, it prints hi Alice. But let's say the user doesn't enter the value Alice as a string, but something else. Let's say you put your name instead of Alice for this particular program, right? And in that situation, it will be a false state. So this if condition will result into a false. Now, once it is false, and let's say you have given input for age as 3000. So age is less than 12, so it is false. Again, it goes here. True will never get executed, so we are still into loop. We are not exited from the loop. So once it gets false, age is greater than 100. Now here, though the age is greater than, age is 3000 we have entered. So age is greater than 100 is true, and age is greater than 2000 is also true. But since our condition is getting true at this stage itself, let me highlight this stage itself. So it will enter the block of the code followed by this elif condition, that is print you are not an Alice granny, right? And eventually it will end up the loop. So that means though our value, the value that we have put, is greater than 2000, which is true for this particular if else condition, elif condition, but this condition will never be checked and this block of code will never be executed. This path will never get executed. It is automatically get skipped. So this cross here indicates that this path will not get the opportunity to get executed, right? So the difference you can clearly make out that we just swapped to elif condition and the flow of the program gets changed, right? So had it been the age greater than 2000 condition on would be before this age greater than 100, then all the four elif conditions would have executed, all the block of the code under all the elif condition gets executed. But here, by just swapping out the elif condition, we were able to change the flow of the program, right? So that's how the conditions can play a role in changing the program. Now let us take a very simple example. Here's a simple program. Let's name it as little kid, right? So here what we are doing is we are checking the name again as it is. If the name is correct, that is if the user has entered as Alice as we have assigned to the placeholder name, it prints hi Alice. And if less than 12, right, is the age is less than 12, print you are not an Alice. Now here is the difference that you can see. We are not writing a elif statement, instead we are putting a else, a simple else statement, right? You can see it's a simple else statement. So you must be already familiar, if it is else, that means if nothing has been executed, this else will get true and the block followed, the block of code followed by else condition will execute. So that means all the above conditions, when the all the above conditions are false, automatically it executes the else part, because else means nothing else. I mean, everything apart from whatever we have given in the if conditions, right? So we have removed the two elif conditions, you can see, and we have brought in only one else condition here. So that means these two conditions, when it gets false, the last statement, the last block of code, which is under else condition, has to get executed, right? So it will execute that you are neither Alice nor a little kid, provided that this condition, these two conditions, gets false. So let me show you the flow chart for that, so that the thing is very clear. So here it is. We have a start, and then if the condition is true, of course it will print hi Alice, and it will end the program. It will end the complete flow of the execution. It has to be false in order to go into elif condition, and once it goes into elif condition, it again checks for the value of age, whether the entered age by the user is less than 12. If it is true, that is this elif condition is true, it will not follow the path of false condition and it will execute the code, the block code under the if the condition is true, it will execute the block code under it, right? So it will execute print statement saying that you are not Alice kiddo, right? But if any of these two condition, both of them have to be false, only then the else part will be executed. So the difference here is in the elif condition, the if condition has to be true, right? If condition has to be true in order to get that executed. But here in else statement, you can see that if nothing is true, then whatever is there in the else part, it has to execute directly, right? So if both of these two statements are false, it will automatically, without checking any further conditions, it will automatically print you are neither Alice nor a little kid, right? So this was just a simple program. Hope the things are clear. Any doubt so far? These are just the simple basics, but still if you have any kind of doubt, let me know. Anybody, any doubt? Yeah, please tell me if there's any doubt. No doubt, okay. Right. So with this, we'll move ahead and discuss the while loop condition, right? We have discussed what is if, what is else, and what is elif statement. Now let us have a understanding of while loop statements. Now you are already familiar with again the while loop, then but how is it different in Python is what we are going to see, right? So like all the other conditional statements, the keyword for while loop is again while, just a while, and the condition, the expression, ultimately whatever the result the while loop provides, it will end up into a boolean value, that is either a true value or a false value. And starting on the next line, that is the block of code under the while loop, the indented block of code is called the while clause. So here we have a simple example that if spam is equal to 0 and while spam is less than 5, print hello world and increment the spam. So before me telling you the answer, can anybody tell me what can be the output for this? The spam has been assigned to value 0, right? And while we have a while loop here, while spam is less than 5, print hello world and increment spam by 1. So can anybody tell me how many times will hello world gets printed, or whether it gets printed or no? Right. Can anybody tell me in the comment section, the chat box? Right. It's a simple while loop statement. The variable spam is assigned to 0, and the spam is checked for the condition while spam is less than 5. We are printing hello world, and then we are incrementing the spam by 1. So it's a simple question, like how many times do we see hello world printed? Anybody? Post it in the
comments. 5 times.
5 times, yeah. Can you explain? It's a simple while loop statement. There is nothing advanced behind it. Can you explain? Yeah. Please go ahead and explain. Maybe in simple, your own terms. It's a simple explanation. I know you guys know this. I just want you to express how are you computing it. Yeah.
Sir, in first step, sir, spam is equals to 0. 0, the while loop condition is checked. 0 less than 5. Then the condition is true, then the print statement will print hello world. Then in next statement, spam is increased by 0 plus 1, that is spam is 1. Mm-hmm. Again the while condition check the condition that 1 is less than 5.
When the spam is equal to 1. Okay, yeah. From 0 it starts and it goes till
4.
And the moment when we increment spam plus 1, when the spam is 5, the condition becomes false and the print will not get executed.
Right? Yes, sir.
So had we assigned spam is equal to 1, then the total number of times the hello world was printed would be 4, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So it's a simple thing, right? So here's a flowchart for it. Like we discussed, like if the condition is true, it will go on print the hello world and also at the same time increment the spam, and if the condition is false, then it directly ends the program. So simple if statement code, like how if statement would be doing. So here is the while loop, similar while statement code, the flowchart for the while statement. Fine. So here is a different, a twist in the program. Let's say we are inputting a name from the user. So we are assigning a variable called name with a blank string. A single open and close quote means a blank variable, right? And we are giving a condition that while this name is not equal to your name, right? While this name is not equal to your name, then print please type your name, right? and at the same time the name is equal to input. That means we are taking input from the user, and ultimately we are printing thank you. So let me show you how this will get executed in the Python IDE. Those who have the Python IDE, or those who are working on your laptop or PC, or maybe as I suggested, have installed Python app on your mobile, you can execute this program along with me. Will you go a little slow so that you get little hands-on, and it shouldn't be just the theoretical part. So I'll be little slow, and I'll keep this program visible to you so that if you are executing, you can make use of this. Fine. So let's say I have declared a variable and also at the same time assigned. So before that, let me open it in the. Let me open a new file and execute the whole program on that. Okay. So name is equal to a blank string. I have not assigned anything. It's a simple open and close single quote which says that the variable name is declared and at the same time assigned with a blank, nothing inside. Okay. And while name is not equal to single quote your name. Now keep this in mind that we are entering this your name in single quote, right? Single quote, that means it's a string. So your name, that is your space name, becomes a string. So it has to be exactly the way we'll be giving the input. It has to be exactly that way when we are comparing, right? So if it is different, it will give us an error. We'll have an execution how it will execute. So let's say if the name is your name, then print type your name. Okay. Let me go a single quote so that it will be printed as a string. And also we are at the same time when we are prompting the user that type your name, we are giving a placeholder name and asking the user to input, and we are calling the input function. And as we discussed in the previous lectures, the input, what it takes is whatever value the user inputs, it stores that value in a form of a string. So for example, had I been asking the user to enter his name or whatever, any particular input which has to have a number, let's say age itself. Had I been asking a user to enter the name, enter age, and I use the input function, then that age, which is in a numerical form, will not be saved in an integer format, but instead in a string value, right? So this we have already discussed in our previous class. And here, once everything is okay, that means when we check that the user has entered the name as your name, then we print, we go out of the loop and we print thank you, right? So let's save it, and I'll name it as simple your name program, your name, right? And dot py. So I press F5 to execute, and it can say, it says, please type your name. So let's say I enter something 43. Okay, so it simply says, type your name. And let's say I print whatever, let's say, okay, again, this is type your name. So it is not taking the name, any particular name as the name, right? So let me put your name. So again, it is not matched. Let me put a space and say your name. It's not matched, right? So the reason being, as you can see that the variable name, it is checking for the while loop that the variable name should be equal to the your name in all in the lowercase, right? So the moment I give value as your name and I hit, it says thank you, right? So the string is checked while it is kind of a loop wherein we are checking while the name that you are enter is your name, the print value, the print statement, that is please type your name, will repeatedly get printed, and at the same time it will give you a cursor to allow you to enter a value for the name. So basically we are printing the prompt message to the user saying please type your name, and at the same time we are calling the input function to give the name. And as you can see, when I enter the correct name, that is your name, then it automatically exits the while loop and prints thank you. And we can see the three right shift operators, right? So the name, I mean the name which is given to this particular loop is an annoying while loop, because it continuously prompts you to enter your name even if you enter your real name or so, right? So this is a simple while loop. Now let's understand the flowchart for this. So here we have a set. Okay, let me zoom in. Here it is not actually a double quote, it is two single quote which has nothing in it, right? So we are assigning, you can see here there's no double equal to, there is just one single equal to sign, which is an assignment operator and not equal to operator. So the name, variable name, is assigned a blank string which consists of nothing, and we are checking for the, we are making use of the while loop here, checking the condition while name is not equal to your name, keep on printing please type your name, and keep on expecting the value, that is the name, the string, from the user by making use of the input function. So it keeps on continuously prompting this message unless and until you enter the your name value as your space name in this all small case letters, right? So the moment we enter your name, the condition gets false, that means it is not equal to your name, gets false, and it says thank you, right? So having said that, let's discuss a simple break statement. As you already know how a break statement would be we would be making use of break statements in simple C program or C++ program. So we make use of break statement whenever we want to, when we achieved what we want in the program, in the flow of the program, and we don't want to execute the further code of it, then we make use of the break statement. So it's like a abrupt end to the loop. So we have used break statements many times in a for loop, in a while loop. So here we have a simple example of a while loop, and we are making use of a break statement here. So you can see here that while true, what true will, or now you can see here true is actually a boolean value, right? It's a predefined boolean value, it's a keyword. This, the capital T and RUE, that is the true value, the true keyword is a predefined word, whereas the small letter true is not a predefined, right? So just to explain you this, you can see if I enter true, you can see the change in the color, right? That defines, that means that the variable true is actually a keyword, predefined keyword. And when I enter true, simple true, in all small case letter, at present the color of the text doesn't get changed. That means the variable is not at all a predefined word. We can use that in our program as a name of a placeholder or something like that, right? So while true, that means we are already giving the permission that the while loop is true, right? So the true value will always be true. That means we are going to execute this block of code under while loop, under while clause. These three line of code, that is print name and if name, these three lines will be definitely getting executed, right? Because we are setting the condition itself is true, true. So while true, print please type your name, and also give the input function to accept the value for the name, and if name is your name, then break, So as you can see that what we discussed in the same program, that when we got the name as your name, we used a break command here, a break statement here in order to get out of the while loop, because while we have set up it to a true. So once it, if it is true, it gets into a kind of an infinite loop, right? Because the condition itself is true, so every time this particular set of code, this particular block of indented code will be executed every time. So in order to exit from this, when we got the name, what we were desired of, that if name is equal to your name, then we made a break statement there, and we ultimately printed a thank you statement at the terminal, right? So this is a simple example of how a break statement can be used to break a loop. The loop can be anything. It can be an infinite loop or maybe in syntax a finite loop, right? Finite loop or infinite loop. So here is the simple flow chart for this, right? We assign the name placeholder as a blank, and what we are doing is we are setting the condition itself is true, right? So there is no chance that this condition will go false, right? There is no chance that this condition will go false. There will be no path with which this this program will execute this path. There is no way that this path will be executed. That is, after this condition, directly print statement will be executed. So it has to go into the while loop. It has to continuously, infinitely print this particular statement unless and until the name value, that is, name is equal to your name, is true, which triggers our break command. And once it is break, only then it is going to print the ultimate print instruction, that is the thank you, right? So this is one example of how a break statement can be handled. So like I said, that X path, that is this path, the path which is generated by X, the X path will logically never happen because the loop condition is always true, right? The condition itself is a true. It's like while one, and for all the value of one, you print this set of codes below the while clause, right? So this is the while clause, right? So there will not be while zero anytime in the program. There will be no condition wherein the while will be false or while will be zero. So this path will never get executed. It has to take this path, make a break command, execute, and then print the thank you prompt message. Okay, so these are the simple conditional statements what we saw, a simple if statement, a simple elif, simple how a elif can be different from a simple else condition, when to use a else condition, when to use a elif condition. Then we learned about what is while loop, how a while loop or a while clause is declared in the Python, which is similar to other languages, and how a flow, more importantly, how a flow can be changed, the flow of the program execution can be changed using these conditional statement, because conditional statements will decide what path to be chosen in order to execute what part of the code we have to execute, right? So these break statements, while statements, elif, else, and if statements, they change the flow of the program. They decide the flow of the execution of a particular program, right? So in the coming lecture, in the next lecture, we'll be discussing about few more conditional statements like continue and all. You must have heard about continue statements, which is something opposite to what we see here in a break statement, right? So as the name suggests, break, it breaks this loop, while as the name suggests, the continue command, it continues to execute the set of code below the clause, right? So we'll have an example, and also we'll have a detailed flow chart of how this complete flow will happen when we execute a program. So we'll take a similar example in the next class. So far, any doubt, any kind of doubt that you have, or any different opinion that what we saw here. Aniket says no doubt. Anybody who is having any kind of doubt, please feel free to ask any doubt, because no doubt is a silly, no question is a silly question. The similar question what it's running in your mind can be a question to your other friend also. If you asked, it might answer, it might be helpful for the other as well. So don't ever hesitate to ask any questions. If you still have any question, you can ask me right now. Yeah, anybody? Or the explanation is very fast or slow, or is it good? I mean, the pace is good. You want a little more fast or slow? Anushka says that the flow is good. Yeah, anybody, any kind of doubt that you want to clarify so far throughout whatever we have discussed, not just with respect to what we discussed today, but anything, anybody who's facing kind of problem while installing Python or using Python ideally in their system or even in mobile phone, in the Android application. Okay, so another, please, one important note, whatever we are discussing here right now, as I've already shared a PDF file of this test work, you, after the lecture, you again go back to those topics that we have discussed in the lecture and try to understand from the test book point of view, also try to understand from taking a different example. So here we are discussing a very simple examples of particular statements, whatever the conditional statements and all. Then you try to execute other programs, taking some different example, try to come up with your own program, which can be on similar lines, but a different program, right? So these are just a simple examples what we are discussing. You can bring changes to this program. You can save those as a file in your file. And later, as I suggested, to create a GitHub account or something, wherein you can store all whatever work that you do, right? So these things might be handy when we collect your assignments. These can be considered as your assignment. So be serious from the beginning itself. Complete these small assignments on daily basis so that you are up to the mark, you are up with the time, right? And don't burden yourself at the end, right? So with this, I'll end up the lecture, but if you still have any doubt, you can reach me anytime, right? So let's conclude the lecture here and make a note of whatever we have discussed so far, and that will be considered as your assignment when you will be coming back, right? So please make a note of whatever we discuss. Thank you. You can leave the meeting.